songs, Rabindranath Tagore was a prolific composer, having written around 2,230 songs. His songs are known as Rabindranath, and they blend seamlessly with his writing, the majority of which were lyricized poetry or sections of novels, stories, or plays. They ranged from his early dirge-like Brahmo-religious hymns to quasi-erotic songs, all influenced by the Thumri style of Hindustani music. To varying degrees, they imitated the tonal color of classical ragas. Some songs perfectly reproduce the melody and rhythm of a certain raga, while others creatively mix components from various ragas. However, about 9/10 of his work was not bhangragan, but rather a collection of songs revitalized with new value from chosen Western, Hindustani, Bengali folk, and other regional flavors external to Tagore's own ancestral culture. Amar Shanar Bangla was adopted as Bangladesh's national anthem in 1971. It was composed, ironically, to oppose the sectarian partition of Bengal in 1905, which divided off the Muslim-majority East Bengal. The goal of the delegation from Hindu-dominated West Bengal was to avert a regional slaughter. Tagore saw partition as a devious attempt to stymie the independent struggle, and he sought to reignite Bengali unity and discourage communalism. Jana Jina Mana is the first of five stanzas in Tagore's Brahmo hymn Bharat Bhajyabhakata written in Sadhu Bhasha, a Sanskritic language of Bengali. It was initially sung at a Calcutta session of the Indian National Congress in 1911. And it was accepted as India's national anthem by the Constituent Assembly of the Republic of India in 1950. Sri Lanka's national anthem was inspired by his work. The song's appeal among Bengalis was such that the Modern Review stated that there is no educated home in Bengal where Rabindranath's songs are not sung, or at least attempted to be sung. Even illiterate villagers sing his songs. Tagore influenced sitarist Vilayat Khan, as well as Sardia's Buddhadev Dasgupta and Amjad Ali Khan. Works of art. Photograph in black and white shows the stylized sketch of a tribal funerary mask. A pastel-colored reproduction of a Malacca mask from Papua New Guinea's northern New Ireland region. Close-up shot in black and white shows a piece of wood boldly painted in unmixed solid strokes of black and white in a stylized resemblance to the Bengali syllabary letters or and the. Tagore's Bengali language initials are carved into this rotho of Rabindranath Thakur, wooden seal, which is artistically comparable to traditional Haida carvings from North America's Pacific Northwest region. Tagore frequently used similar art to adorn his writings. Tagore began sketching and painting at the age of 60, and successful exhibitions of his various works, which made their debut in Paris thanks to the support of painters he met in the south of France, were held around Europe. He was most likely red-green colorblind, which resulted in works with unusual color schemes and odd aesthetics. Tagore was influenced by a variety of styles, including scrimshaw by the Malanga people of northern New Ireland, Papua New Guinea, Haida carvings from North America's Pacific Northwest region, and woodcuts by the German Max Echstein. His artist's eye for handwriting was evident in the simple creative and rhythmic leitmotifs adorning his manuscript scribbles, cross-outs, and word layouts. Some of Tagore's songs were synesthetic ally related to specific artworks. Surrounded by a group of painters, Rabindranath has always wished to be a painter. Writing, music, playwriting, and acting came effortlessly and nearly without training to him, as they did to several others in his family, and to a greater extent. However, painting eluded him. Nonetheless, he attempted to perfect the technique on numerous occasions, as evidenced by several references to this in his early letters and reminiscences. For example, in 1900, when he was nearly 40 and already a well-known writer, he wrote to Jagadish Chandra Bose, "You will be startled to hear that I am sitting with a sketchbook drawing. Needless to say, the images are not of high quality. They appear to be designed for any salon in Paris, but I have a strong fear that any country's national gallery will suddenly decide to raise taxes to purchase them. But much as a mother lavishes the greatest love on her ugliest son, I am secretly drawn to the skill that comes the least effortlessly to me. He also discovered he was using the eraser more than the pencil, and displeased with the results, he withdrew, concluding that becoming a painter was not for him. Politics. Tagore was an outspoken opponent of imperialism and a supporter of Indian nationalists, and his ideas were initially expressed in manas, which he wrote primarily in his 20s. Evidence presented at the Hindu-German conspiracy trial and later testimonies confirm his knowledge of the Gadarenes, and he sought the cooperation of Japanese Prime Minister Teruichi Masatake and former Premier Kuma Shijinbu. Nonetheless, he mocked the Swadeshi movement in The Cult of the Charka, an acidic 1925 essay. Tagore, according to Amartya Sen, revolted against the independence movement's aggressively nationalist expressions, and he sought to proclaim India's right to freedom without ignoring the relevance of what India could learn from overseas. He urged the masses to reject victimology in favor of self-help and education, and he considered British administration as a political manifestation of our social disease. Even for the poorest of the poor, he believed, there can be no thought of blind revolution. Instead, a steady and intentional education was preferred. So, once again, we can never have a full view of man until we love him. Civilization must be assessed and valued not by the amount of power it has amassed, but by how far it has progressed and expressed, through its laws and institutions, humanity's love, said Hanna, The Realization of Life, 1916. Such viewpoints infuriated many people. During his stay at a San Francisco hotel in late 1916, he narrowly missed assassination by Indian expatriates. The plot failed when his would-be assassins got into a dispute. Tagore composed songs that glorified the Indian independence fight. Two of Tagore's most politically charged pieces, Chitto Jetha Bhikshuni, Where the Mind is Without Fear, and Akila Chalon Re, If They Do Not Answer Thy Call, Walk Alone, were popular, with Gandhi favoring the latter. Despite his reservations about Gandhian agitation, Tagore was instrumental in ending a conflict. Gandhi Ambedkar squabble concerns separate electorates for untouchables, putting at least one of Gandhi's unto-death fasts on the table, refusal of knighthood. In response to the Jallianwala Bagh tragedy in 1919, Tagore surrendered his knighthood. He wrote in his repudiation letter to the Viceroy, Lord Chelmsford, "The day has come when badges of honor make our shame visible in the incongruous setting of humiliation, and I, for one, wish to stand by the side of those of my compatriots who, because of their so-called insignificance, are liable to experience degradation unfit for human beings." Santanikton and Visva Bharati. Tagore disliked rote classroom education. In The Parrot's Training, a parrot is imprisoned and force-fed textbook pages until it dies. During a visit to Santa Barbara in 1917, Tagore envisioned a new form of university, making Santanikton the connecting thread between India and the world, and a world center for the study of humanity somewhere beyond the limits of nation and territory. Tagore used the Brahmacharya system, in which gurus provided students with emotional, intellectual, and spiritual direction. Teaching was frequently done in the shade of trees. He staffed the school, he donated his Nobel Prize money, and his duties as steward mentor at Santanikton kept him busy. He taught lessons in the mornings and prepared textbooks for the students in the afternoons and evenings. Between 1919 and 1921, he raised a lot of money for schools in Europe and the United States. Theft of Nobel Prize. Tagore's Nobel Prize, as well as several of his valuables, were taken from the Visva Bharati University's safekeeping vault on March 25, 2004. On December 7, 2004, the Swedish Academy decided to award the Visva Bharati University with two copies of Tagore's Nobel Prize, one in gold and the other in bronze. It was the inspiration for the fictional film Nobel Cord. In 2016, A bail singer named Pratapaberi was arrested on suspicion of harboring the thieves, and the prize was returned.